Anybody happy that God woke them up this morning? Come on, let's give God some praise on this morning. Are you thankful that you made it through the week? Are you thankful that your children didn't drive you crazy? That you woke up in your right mind on this morning? We thank God for our health and strength on this morning. Hallelujah. Lord, we come to you on this morning, God, thanking you yet for another day. Father, we thank you for waking us up this morning. Lord God, you loved us enough to allow us to see another day, God. Lord, you so fit that we will see this day, Lord God. Another opportunity to give you praise, oh God. Another opportunity to lift our hands and say thank you, Lord God. Another opportunity to give you our worship on this morning. Lord God, we thank you on today, Lord God. Because you didn't have to do it, but you did, God. Father, we honor you on this morning. We thank you for being a good God. We thank you for being a faithful God. God, you were faithful to us even when we wasn't faithful to you, oh God. Lord God, you loved us even when we didn't love ourselves, oh God. Lord God, you kept us even through our mess, oh God. Even when we was out in the world sinning, oh God. You continue to love us, oh God. And you loved us right through our mess, oh God. Lord God, you even blessed us through our mess, oh God. Because you gave us life, Lord God. And life more abundantly, oh God. Lord God, we thank you this morning for Jesus, oh God. Lord God, he got up on that cross, oh God. And he submitted to your will, oh God. He was obedient unto you, oh God. That he laid down his life, oh God. That we may have life and life more abundantly, oh God. How dare we not enjoy our life, oh God. How dare we not enjoy the life that you have given us, oh God. Lord God, we repent right now, God. We repent for not enjoying our life, oh God. Because you gave your only begotten son, oh God. That we may have life and life more abundantly, oh God. Lord God, I thank you on this morning. I thank you for every leader in the house, God. I thank you for the bishop and the first lady, God. Lord God, I thank you that you're expanding their territories, oh God. Lord God, I thank you that you're expanding their capacity to receive, oh God. To receive something they could have never imagined to receive, oh God. Lord God, I thank you on this morning, God. God, thank you for your faithfulness, oh God. Thank you for your strength, oh God. Thank you for the Holy Ghost power that resides in us, oh God. Lord God, give us a heart to receive you on this morning. Give us a mind to receive, oh God. Give us an ear to hear your word, oh God. Oh God, we ask that you bless the man that's going to bring forth the word on this morning. God, put the words in his mouth that he will speak what you are having to speak. Say what you are having to say and do what you tell him to do in the name of Jesus. Bless our young people on this morning. And Lord God, put the songs in their heart, God. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, and amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm chasing after you, no matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more. No matter what I have to do, 'cause I need you more and more.
I'm chasing after you.
No matter what
I have to do,
'cause I need you
more.
just to be close to you. I'm chasing after you.
I'm chasing after you.
I'm praising my way through.
I'm praising my way through.
Just to be close to you.
Yeah. depths of your soul to sing, great are you, Lord.
Great are you, Lord.
Even when my situation's a little crazy, we sing, great are you, Lord.
Great are you, Lord.
Oh, sing, great are, great are,
great.
It's your breath in our lungs, so we pour out our praise, pour out our praise. It's your breath, sing it
in our lungs,
so
we pour out our praise
to you.
It's your breath
in my lungs. I have no choice but
pour out.
No rock's gonna cry out for me.
Hallelujah.
Isn't he great? Isn't my God great? Heaven's gonna sound like, so sing great.
Great are you, Lord.
Great, one more time, say great. Fullness of eternal promise, stirring in your sons and daughters, earth revealing heaven's wonders. So Spirit come, Spirit. You spoke is now unfolding, and all your children shall behold it, and dreams awaken in this moment. Sing it now.
Spirit come.
The world awaits your presence, and then this power is within us, and we will rise to be your witness. Say,
Spirit come.
Say it.
Spirit come.
Pour it out, Lord.
Let your love run over.
Right.
testifying of the Son, one desire.
Holy Spirit, come.
Spirit, come.
Speak revival.
Speak revival.
Prophesy
like it is done. One desire.
Holy Spirit, come.
Spirit, come. Spirit, come.
Holy Spirit, come.
Let our hearts continue burning, yes, for our King is soon returning. And as we hold to this assurance, say,
Spirit, come.
Spirit, come.
Spirit, come.
Pour glory on each and every one of us.
your glory. We can't do nothing without you. So I need your power, Lord. Your anointing on my life.
Come on, let's give it up for our youth praise. Come on. Give it up for our youth praise team. Give me some more. Hello. Amen. Listen, once a quarter, we shut everything down but the main sanctuary and the nursery area, and we combine the two services. Just look around. Bring the lights up if you don't mind. Amen. Would you just look around, and would you shake someone's hand? Would you hug their neck? Would you tell them, hey, good to see you in the house of the Lord? And if you don't know their name, tell them, my name is... We want to welcome our IKP kids back from Kids Fest. Where's the IKP kids? Where are you guys? Raise your hand. Whoop! From what I understand, around the altar, many different things happened, but three of them were filled with the power of the Holy Spirit. Can we give God praise for that? Good to have them back. Listen. We're going to pass these out. I believe we ordered about 200 of them, if you will. We're going to have to order some more. But the new IP bumper sticker, amen. You put on your bumper, you can put it on your window. I got mine right in the middle of my window on the back of my vehicle. If you're proud to be a part of the IP family, amen, get yourself a bumper sticker and put it on there. This is what I ask. If you put one of these on your car, make sure when you wave at people that all five fingers are up. Amen. You represent God and you represent IP. Also, this Friday night, everybody say this Friday night from 6 p.m. This is totally different, guys. This is something we've never done before. But from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m., we're going to have our spring outdoor bash. Amen. And everyone's welcome. Bring your family and friends. We're going to have free hot dogs and hamburgers and, in other words, junk food. But there's going to be a lot of different. There's going to be jump houses, rock climbing walls, hay rides, amen, different games that the youth and children are putting together. And we're just excited about this Friday night. Bring your own chair. Bring your own chair. If you have one of those 10x10 pop-ups, bring your 10x10 pop-up, if you will, and let's just have a great time of fellowship. Also, from 4 p.m. to 8 p.m., we're going to have a blood drive. Amen. And I know some of you just got a little dampered, if you will. But listen, if you'd like to support the American Red Cross and come out and help, if you will, by donating blood, we'd love for you to do that. There's a sign-up sheet in the Welcome Center. You can sign up for a specific hour or a specific time in order for you to come by and give in your by giving to the Red Cross. Amen. We'd like to welcome our guests with us this morning. This young lady and her is no stranger to us. She was here with us a few years ago. her family moved out of state and moved again back into Kentucky, from what I understand. But now she comes back this morning. She's married. Amen. We know her as Emily Lawrence. Amen. But now she's married to Cody. And this is Cody and Emily Gillum. Is it Gillum or Gilliam? Amen. Give them a good international praise and welcome. Raise your hand. They're on their way to the Bahamas. Amen. On their way to the Bahamas. And they are just decided to stop in. And it's always a privilege to have them. All right. Rodney and Rachel McCann. Where's Rodney and Rachel? Raise your hand. Rodney and Rachel. Raise your hand real high. Rodney and Rachel. Do I see? That ain't you, Zachary. Amen. My grandson raised his hand. Rodney and Rachel. All right, y'all scared them off. I'm only kidding. They don't want to raise their hand. All right, Damon and Diamano. Where's Damon? Raise your hand. Damon, where's your... Damon, good to have Damon with us this morning. All right. How about Bonnie Thompson? Bonnie Thompson. Bonnie, is that Bonnie right there? There's Bonnie right there. All right. How about Amber and Ashton Hancock? Where are you guys? Amber and Ashton Hancock. Where? Good to have you guys. Give all of our guests a good international praise welcome. All right. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord this morning. On the fifth Sunday of every quarter, we also receive new members in. So if you are our guest this morning, you'll get to see how we receive new members. Amen. Sister Hannah, where are you? You're waiting till next time, for what I understand. Is that correct? I want to make sure. All right. I'm going to call your names. And if you would, please line up as we discussed earlier this morning. Ferris Bolin and Priscilla Bolin and Kobe Moore, if you guys would come. If the Burrows would come, Alexander, Melvin, and Naomi, and Stephanie, and William, if you guys would come, please. Next up is the Chapmans. Amen. The Chapmans would come. Brian, Charlene, Jordan, and Nehemiah. Pharisee changed it up on me. All right. Latanya Colson. Latanya. There's Latanya. DeJaris Douglas. Sister DeJaris. Guys, by the way, this morning we have a privilege of having our youth pastor speaking for us this morning. Would y'all give it up for Chris Chambers? All right. Courtney Evans, are you here? Courtney, if you are, raise your hand. All right. And how about Kanisha Fields? Okay. Elijah and Cherie James. Give it up for Elijah and Cherie. How about Cheryl Lewis Cole? Cheryl Lewis Cole. LaKenya Middleton. LaKenya Middleton. And Colby Moore. He's already, oh, that's right. I'm sorry. I told you I'd have a mistake somewhere. How about Tony and Regina Player? Give it up for Tony and Regina. Deshaun Reese. I got it. Okay, gotcha. And Alexa Taylor and Tykel Taylor and Janet Simmons. They're coming. How about Charlene Walker? Charlene Walker. I'm going to tell you what, this is a good-looking group of people, isn't it? Amen. How about Gina Bacote? Gina, did I say it right? Gina and Layla Bacote. Amen. All right. Dion Amira and Christopher Bethel. We may have to shift them from left to right now. How about the Owens family? James and Lana, Deja and Jalen Owens. We're just about there, guys. How about Evelyn Banks? Sister Evelyn. Where is she? She coming? Is she related to you? No? Well, we are related somehow, right? How about Shirley Flood? Where's Shirley? Sister Shirley. How about the Cruz family? Anthony, Jennifer, Anthony Jr., Lindsay, and Michaela. Give it up for the Cruz family. If you are on the end and you can't see me, you should be able to just swing out just a little bit, but I think everyone should be able to see me. This is the first time that we've had the center aisle, and this works pretty good, all right? All right. You realize in presenting yourself for membership that you are assuming a solemn obligation, and it is expected that you shall always be true to your vow and faithfully fulfill and discharge your obligation as a loyal member. Do you publicly confess and testify that you know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior in the full pardon of your sins? If you do, say, I do. Are you willing to walk in the light of the Scripture as it shines upon your path? If you will, say, I will. Are you willing to abide by and subscribe to the discipline of the Church of God as outlined by Scripture and set forth in the minutes of the General Assembly? If you will, say, I will. Are you willing to support the church with your attendance and temporal means, meaning you're given to the best of your ability, as the Lord shall so prosper you? If you will, say, I will. Do you agree to be subject to the counsel and admonition of those who are over you in the Lord? If you do, say, I do. If there be any member who has a legal objection to any of these becoming members of the church, the objector may now so state. By the authority vested in me as a minister of the Church of God, I take great pleasure in welcoming you into the International Praise Church of God family. Come on, give God praise if you don't mind. Amen. Hold your place. Congregation, would you stretch your hands this way and let's pray for them. Father, we thank you for the choice servants that you've sent to IP as to be a part of this church family. And God, we pray that, God, that they would invest their talent, their time, their treasure into working for your kingdom. So, Lord, we ask your blessings to rest upon them in every area of their life. So, Lord, once again, help us to be good stewards of what you've given to us as well. God, we surrender it all to you right now. And we thank you, Lord, for the people that are added to this church family in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen. Amen. Let's continue to worship as we give the right hand of fellowship to all of these. Amen.
Say, bless, bless,
bless.
For the devil is, for the devil is defeated. We will bless, pray, bless, yes.
We're blessed in the city. We're blessed in the field.
Yes, we are.
We're blessed when we come and when we go.
We cast down every stronghold, sickness and poverty. For the devil is,
for the devil is defeated.
We are blessed. Since thou hast walked the right lane, the light and of the land, since thou hast placed in my heart all the Lord command. He placed thee above the nation and cast thy enemies away. He's standing up beside you, so let me hear you say,
we're blessed in the city, we're blessed in the field, we're blessed when we come and when we go. Stronghold, sickness, and poverty.
For the devil is,
for the devil is defeated. We are blessed.
Now the sun is given only. Put no confidence in man. Everything you have before you, he placed it in his hand. Though our hopes rise up against you and try to spoil your day, they come in one way, but they win seven ways.
We're blessed. We're blessed in the field. We're blessed when we come and when we go. We cast down every stronghold, sickness and poverty.
For the devil is,
for the devil is defeated. We are blessed.
Late in the midnight hours, God's gonna turn around. He's gonna work in your favor. Yes, he is.
Come on, let's give it up for all of these that have joined IP. Amen. All right, while they're still greeting them, amen, let me just make a few announcements, if you will. Tonight at 6 o'clock, we're having a district rally at the Grace Community Church of God there on Rabin Road. It's 308 Rabin Road. Amen. Come out. Let's fill that house up. Amen. Let's have a good time with our brothers and sisters in the Lord. 6 o'clock, Grace Community, 308 Raven Road. If you want directions, the information is out at the Welcome Center. Also, we have Praying for Pentecost. These were passed out. This week's devotion, focus on purity of heart and motive. Amen. So go by Welcome Center and pick that up as well. And let's pray leading up to Pentecost. I'm going to ask if everyone would please stand with me as we prepare to partake in communion this morning. While they sing one stanza of that, if you don't mind, let's just worship the Lord.
We'll wash clean, now we have the victory. The power of sin is broken, Jesus overcame it all. Yeah. He has won our freedom. Jesus has won it all. Yeah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You have won the victory.
Come on, lift your voices.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Ask if you would please take a moment as a reflection upon your life, for the Bible warns that we should not partake in communion in an unworthy manner. So if there's anything standing between you and the Lord right now, as I say this prayer, would you make it a point of confession for yourself? Father, if there's anything standing between me and you, knowingly or unknowingly, I ask for your forgiveness. I plead the blood of Jesus upon my life. In Jesus' name, amen. Ask if you will, take your elements, if you will. Peel back the first layer, exposing your wafer. Once you have it exposed, if you just hold it up in your hand. The Word of God says, and as they were eating, Jesus took bread and blessed it and broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, take, eat, this is my body. Let us pray. Father, every day I live, I give you praise for what you've done for me, what you've done for us. And Lord, every time I see a believer at that point of leaving this world and going to another, I give you praise. Because, Lord, that's where our hope resides. Because of what you did for us thousands of years ago on the cross of Calvary, you changed my life because you gave your body. You offered yourself for me on the cross of Calvary. Because of that, my sins have been conquered by you, the Son of God. So, Father, we thank you for what you've done with your Son. We thank you for your Son for what he's done for us. In Jesus' name, amen. If you would, please take your cup, peel back the second layer of your cup. The Word of God says, and he took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, drink ye all of it. For this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many for the remission of sins. Let's pray. Father, thank you for the blood of your Son, Jesus, who gave himself freely on the cross of Calvary. Because of what he's done on the cross of Calvary, my sins have been washed away. Because when we go to the cross, that blood covers our sin. Your word declares that without blood, there is no remission of sins. So, Father, we thank you for that. We thank you that, spiritually speaking, the blood of the Lamb of God has been applied to the doorpost of my heart, and my life has been changed ever since. I thank you for it. We give you praise for it. In Jesus' name, amen. If you would, please take your communion cup, pass them towards the center aisle, and the ushers will be more than happy to assist you. Time, give it up for the Lord for what he's done for you. Amen. You ready to give this morning? Say amen. Grab a hold of your tithe and your offering as the ushers get ready to wait upon you. And let's do our confession and offering time. Here we go. As we give today in our offerings, we're believing the Lord for jobs or better jobs, benefits, raises and bonuses, sales and commission, settlements of estates and inheritances, rebates and returns, gifts and surprises, bills paid off, debts demolished, witty inventions, an entrepreneurial spirit for the advancement of the kingdom, and blessings for our families. It's offering time. Hallelujah. Men, continue to worship after the announcements and worship.
Good morning, International Praise. The Global Leadership Conference will be August 9th and 10th. The time is now to register.
Attention all seniors, our South Carolina Senior Adult Retreat will be held at our Church of God Convention Center in Malden, May the 25th and 26th. Stop by the Connect Center for more information and to register.
Are you graduating from high school, college, grad, or tech school? We want to honor you on Sunday, May the 20th. Please visit our Connect Center or the website to send in your information. Our 11th Hispanic Women's Conference is Friday, May the 11th at 7 p.m. and Saturday, May the 12th, 8 to 4 p.m. Registration is $25. Please visit our website or the Connect Center to register. Time is winding down to recognize a volunteer. Please visit our website or the Connect Center to submit a nomination. Our family and friends outdoor spring bash will be this Friday, May the 4th from 6 to 10 p.m. Lots of fun, free food, games, movie, and other activities. Red Cross will be doing a blood drive from 4 to 6 p.m. Please tape several cards and invite someone. Hope to see you there. Connect and get involved by volunteering in a ministry and becoming a part of a life group. Join us for word and prayer on Saturdays at 8 a.m. Now, let's shout it out together. Love God, love others, and reach the world.
Create me to fear, but you created me to worship daily, so I'ma leave it all right here. trust in you, Lord, I will put my trust in you.
You love us, how you love us. Thank you for the way you have made us. We were created for your pleasure, for your presence, for the glory of your name. So thank you for the way that you love us. Thank you.
Thank you for the way
that you love
us. How you love us. Thank you for the way
you
have made us.
We were created, say,
we were created
for your pleasure,
for your pleasure,
for your presence,
for your presence,
for the glory,
for the glory of your name.
Jesus,
faithful King, oh, with grateful hearts we sing, how great is the love, how great is the love of our Savior.
So thank you for the
grateful hearts we sing.
that you love us,
how we love,
how you love us.
I wanna say thank
you for the way
that you love us, so
that you love us.
Oh, how you love us,
how
so
you love us.
Oh, I wanna say thank
you.
Say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Come on, give him thanks in the house.
Thank
he didn't have Lord. To do it, but he did. Because he's faithful to his word. He's faithful to you and myself. He is a good God. And how great is the love that saved us. Come on, church. Lord, we thank you. God, we thank you for the love. God, we magnify you. We honor you, Lord, because of that love that you have poured out in abundance, God, that we can have life. Thank you, Jesus. Sometimes you got to tell them. You got to tell yourself to say thank you. Because sometimes the situation might not be right. It might not be the time to thank them. But it's the time to thank them. Because when you take that grateful attitude, when you take that thankfulness and say, God, things might not be right what I can see, but I know you're moving things in the spiritual realm. And then when you start thanking them, walls begin to come down. Come on, man. You got to push yourself. You got to activate your faith sometimes. Go ahead and thank him for the freedom that you're going to receive this morning because he's faithful. Go ahead and thank him in advance for restoration. Go ahead and thank him in advance for healing. Come on.
Your cross,
the weight of your cross,
the curse of our shame.
Go ahead, give him thanks. He's a good God. He's still on the throne. He's still working miracles. He's still changing lives. He's still saving souls. Come on, come on. I want to thank our bishop and first lady for allowing me to speak this morning. They are absolutely the best. They are absolutely the best. I want to thank you, church, for allowing us to be here and minister to your teenagers. Parents, thank you for allowing us. It is a privilege and an honor to work with these kids. And I love you, church. I'm nervous, and I'm going to let God be God this morning. Is that all right? Let's pray. Let's pray. Dear God, I thank you for this phenomenal day that you have planned and you have purposed for each and every one of us today. God, I pray that you would open our hearts and our minds to receive your presence, your word, your truth, and the freedom that you have already poured out and is made available to every single individual in this room. Father, I pray that you would open our eyes today to see your goodness and mercy. God, I pray that you would help me to hide behind the shadow of the cross, and that you would receive all glory and all honor for lives being changed today in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said, amen. You may be seated. I'm going to attempt to read quite a bit of scripture. We will see how that plays out. But if you don't mind, turn to 2 Kings chapter 4 and verses 8 through 37. It's a long, long chapter, but I want to go through this detailed and I want to break it down. And 2 Kings chapter 4, starting in verse 8. It is going to be a long, so bear with me. If I lose you, just raise your hand or throw something at me. That's what the teenagers usually do in youth service. I'm just kidding. They don't throw anything. I'm just kidding. Now there came a day when Elisha went over to Shunem, where there was a prominent and influential woman, and she persuaded him to eat a meal. Afterwards, whenever he passed by, he stopped there for a meal, and she said to her husband, "Behold, I sense that this is a holy man of God who frequently passes our way. Please let us make a small, fully wrapped, fully walled upper room on the housetop, and there let's put a bed for him with a table, a chair, and a lampstand. Then whenever he comes to visit, he can turn there." If you're standing for the reading, you may be seated because it's going to be a lot. I'm sorry. I hope that doesn't offend anybody. But if you want to stand, you're more than welcome to stand. Absolutely. One day he came there and he turned into the upper room and lay down to rest. And he said to Gehazi, his servant, "Call this Shunammite." So he called her, and she stood before him. Now he said to Gehazi, "Say to her now, 'You have gone to all of this trouble for us, so what can I do for you? Would you like to be mentioned to the king or to the captain of the army?'" She answered him, and she says, "Listen, I live among my own people in peace and security and need no special favor." Later, Elisha said, "What then is to be done for her?" And Gehazi answered, "Well, she has no son, and her husband is old." He said, "Call her." So Gehazi called, and she came in, and she stood in the doorway. Elisha said, "At this very season, next year, you will embrace a son." She said, "No, my Lord. Oh, my man of God, do not lie to your maidservant." I'm going to pause right there, and we'll get into the other scriptures as we go forward. And Jason, media team, I'm jumping ahead, and I apologize. At this moment, this lady, her desire is to please God. Everything that her husband and her had come into agreement, they were one. They were together. Can you say together? They were together, and they had fed this man. They took care of the man of God. They built a room. They spent their money. They furnished it. And she said, I can tell, I have a sense of discernment that this is a man of God. Now, how does she know that this is a man of God? Have you ever heard of the phrase, it takes one to know one? You know how we used to, as kids, to say, well, you're a dork or whatever your saying was when you were a kid. Well, it takes one to know one, you know? And this really hit me because if she was able to discern that this was a holy man of God, that means she had to be in the presence of God. You understand what I'm saying? So she could tell what was going on. She was in that place with God herself. Amen? So when she takes care and the husband takes care of the man of God, they build this room, they feed him every time he comes by, and they furnish the room. What is her intention? Where is her heart? Her desire is to honor God in everything that they do. Her desire, her motive was to honor God. She didn't ask for anything in return. And even when the man of God said, what can we do for you? She said, we're good. I live with my own people. I'm good. I'm good. And then the man of God says, wait a minute. We've got to do something for her. And then when he says, he doesn't even ask her this time. I love that. He says, at this time next year, you're going to have a baby. And you can see the desire for her to have a child is brought to the surface. And she says, no, please, man of God, do not lie to me. You can see the desire, the hidden desire that she had to have a child was brought forth, number one, because she honored God. She honored God in her motive, everything that she did, her breath, her very movements, everything she did was to honor God. That was her motive, was just to honor God. And then all of a sudden, God flips that thing. He says, wait a minute, I'm going to honor you with a child. Amen? All right, in verse 18, and when, in verse 17, but the woman conceived and gave birth to a son that season the next year, just as Elisha had said to her. In verse 18, when the child was grown, the day had come out when he went to his father, to the reapers. He went out to work. But he said to his father, my head, my head. The man said to his servant, carry him to his mother. When he had carried and brought him to his mother, the child sat on her lap until noon, and then he died. She went up and laid him on the bed of the man of God where Elisha was staying and shut the door of the small upper room behind him and left. Then she called to her husband and said, please send me one of the servants and one of the donkeys so that I may run to the man of God, where you're running to, and return. He said, why are you going to him today? It's neither new moon nor the Sabbath. And she said, it will be all right. It will be all right. There's another version that says, it is well. She didn't waver in her faith. She stayed true to where she was at. Not moved by her circumstances. You understand what I'm saying? Then she saddled her donkey and said to her servant, drive the animal fast. Do not slow down and pace for me, unless I tell you. She set out and came to the man of God at Mount Carmel. When the man of God saw her at a distance, he said to Gehazi, his servant, he said, look, there's that Shunammite woman. Please run now to meet her and ask, is it well with you? Is it well with your husband? Is it well with your child? And she answered, it is well. See, Gehazi, that, if you read on in the chapter, he had ulterior motives. He ended up stealing from a man of God. There was ulterior motives. And guess what? She had discernment to see that. You know what? Sometimes we can't tell everything going on in our life because sometimes people are not going to have the faith and encourage you to get where you're supposed to be. Get to the presence of God. Tell somebody, get to the presence of God. In that journey, it was about a 20 to 30 mile distance to get to them. And, you know, if you ride a donkey, and I think it was between 4 and 6 hours to take you to get there, so then you got to come back. I could just imagine she was just praying the whole way. It is well. It is well. It is well. When the man of God saw her, he said to Gehazi, look, there is a Shunammite woman. Please run and meet her and ask, is it well with you? Is it well with your husband? Is it well with child? And she answered, it is well. When she came to the mountain, to the man of God, she took hold of his feet. She lowered herself and she grabbed hold of his feet. And Gehazi approached to push her away, but the man of God said, let her alone. See, even in her distress, Gehazi couldn't even tell. And he was close to the man of God. What was going on? He approached to push her out of the way, but the man of God said, let her alone, for her soul is desperate and troubled within her, and the Lord has hidden the reason from me and has not told me. Then she said, did I ask for a son, my Lord? Did I not say, do not give me false hope? Man, we got to make sure the hope we're giving out to people is from God. Then he said to Gehazi, gird up your loins and prepare now and take my staff in your hand and go to the woman's house. If you meet any man along the way, do not greet him. And if he greets you, do not even greet him. Do not stop to answer him. And lay my staff on the face of the boy as soon as you reach the house. And the mother of this child said, as the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you. So Elisha said, wait a minute. He arose and he said, I got to follow this woman. Gehazi went on ahead of them and laid his staff on the boy's face, but there was no sound, there was no response from the boy. So he turned back to meet with Elisha and told him the boy had not awakened. When Elisha had come into the house, the child was dead and lying on the bed. So he went in and he shut the door behind the two of them. Sometimes you got to get in the prayer closet, shut the door, and leave your stuff out there. Don't be telling your business out there. You understand? He shut the door behind the two of them, and he prayed to the Lord. He knew where his source was. Then he went up, and he laid on the child. He put his mouth on his mouth, his eyes on his eyes, and his hands on his hands. And he stretched himself out on him, and he held him, and the boy's skin became warm. He got up, and then he returned. Then he returned and walked in the house once back and forth. I get where we get the Pentecostals of walking back and forth. I understand it now. And he went up again and he stretched himself out on the boy. And the boy sneezed 7 times and he opened his eyes. Then Elisha called Gehazi and said, call the Shunammite. So he called her. And when she came in, he said, pick up your son. And you know what she did? In verse 37, she came in and fell at his feet. She still knew that it was because of God. Bowing herself to the ground in respect and gratitude, then she picked up her son and left. Several notes that I want to point out about this woman. She lived in Shunem. That means a double resting place. A double resting place. I'm not talking about a zip code. I'm talking about her spirit where she stayed with the Lord. Is anybody here? There's a resting place. There's something that happened, and I'm going to tell you a little bit later on that happened to me, but there's a place where you can get where we can just rest. And that's where we're supposed to stay. Because when we get up from our position of rest and we start trying to fix things, then God, it ties his hands up. Says, God, I don't trust you. But when you stay in that place of rest, that is the best place that you can ever be. Come on. She stayed in Shunem, which means a double resting place. Does somebody need some rest this morning? Because she lived in that place, she had discernment to see that Elisha was a holy man. She said in verse 9, she said, behold, I sense this is a holy man of God who frequently passes our way. Point two, she honored God in her heart, and therefore she honored in her actions. That was the first place. I said earlier, you've got to shut the door sometimes, and you and God have got to get alone. There's so much noise in the world. There's so much noise in the church sometimes that we just get busy and busy and busy, and we lose focus. We lose our ability to hear God's voice. And that's what we're supposed to do. That's the very first thing we're supposed to do. She honored God in her actions, in her heart and in her actions. She took care of the man of God by feeding him. She built a room and she furnished it. She made his needs priority. Scripture says that what you make happen for others, God will in turn make happen for you. I don't have my cell phone, but we're in a selfie generation where we got to take a selfie about everything we do. We need to take a hymn. We need to point to him instead of a selfie generation. Number three, her pursuit was God. It was not for herself. It was not for herself. Number four, and I'm blowing through these, brother. I hope you're keeping up with me. I'm sorry. Her pursuit was God, and it was not herself. And then when she was blessed, when God turned it upside down for her and brought her to her desires to the surface, she remained humble. She remained humble. And he said in 12, he said to Gehazi's servant, call the Shunammite. So he called, and she stood before him. And now Gehazi said to her, now you have gone to all this trouble. God sees your labor. God sees your work. The things that you do and nobody knows, God sees it. That's where we're supposed to be. We're supposed to be hiding behind the cross. Why? Because God gets the glory, not you, not me. Would you like me to mention to the king or the captain? She says, no, I'm good. And that's the statement. She says, no, it is well with me. She didn't ask for anything, even when the man of God said, what can we do for you? The next point, because she put God's will above her own, he gave her a child. Every woman's desire is to have a child. She placed God way up here. She said, God, your will, not mine. I'm not focusing on what I need or what I want. But my focus is on you. And I will worship you, whether I'm feeding somebody, I'm building a room for somebody, I'm sweeping up the floors, I'm cleaning up the bathrooms. I'm going to worship you, God. I'm going to put your house, I'm going to put you, your will, not mine. And that's just like God, to turn it and to bring those hidden desires. I pray some of y'all are getting this. 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 In Jesus' name. But the woman conceived and gave birth to a son that next year. When we seek his presence, when we seek his will, he knows exactly what we need and when we need it. The last point, and I'm not done by no means, so don't get ready to leave. She said she stayed in her resting place. Listen, I know it's difficult, and I didn't understand this until a few years ago, but you've got to stay in your resting place. You've got to stay in the presence of God. You've got to fight. You've got to do what you have to do. Cole, come here, please, sir. Come here. See, this is kind of what it's like. Cole and I are friends, and he's a good young man, and so it's not going to be, but give me a hug. Yeah, give me a hug. Give me a hug. Is this weird?
Yeah.
It is weird. He's turning red. See, a lot of times, thank you. Taylor, come here. A lot of times, Lord, help me. A lot of times we get into the presence of God, and it's weird, it's awkward, because we ain't been there. We hadn't been there in a while. Taylor, give me a hug. Taylor, is this weird?
No.
Do you like this?
Yeah.
This is my baby. This is my baby. This is my daughter. And that's just like God. By the way, she got filled with the Holy Ghost this weekend, and I give God praise for it. Go sit down. Let me tell you something. We don't know what we're supposed to do when we get into the presence of God, and all he wants us to do is crawl up in his lap, place your head on his chest. When I come home and that baby comes and they give me a hug and she hears my heartbeat, it's the best place in the world. A few years ago, when I had to resign as a youth pastor, it was absolutely one of the toughest things I had to do. But I knew God was directing me. And it was a peace and it was a freedom. It was tough. And I went on this journey and I felt like he was leading me into the wilderness. And I'm glad he was leading me, because he was feeding me in the wilderness. He was giving me strength in the wilderness. And there was times, I'm not going to lie, we visited, we were searching, I was searching for God. And the thing about it is, I was a Christian, I was a youth pastor, but yet I still had struggles. You understand what I'm saying? I still got hurt. I still dealt with things. I'm human. And I was searching for God, and I said, and I remember, I'm like, God, where are you? I'm searching. And I remember, I don't remember dates very well. I remember my wife's anniversary, my anniversary. I remember our kids' birthdays. You know what I'm saying? But I remember February 6, 2016, because I had been searching for God, and I think I stepped down around June of 15. And in February 6, 2016, I was in a church and I was seeking God, and I wasn't searching for anything. You understand what I'm saying? My motive, my desire was to be in his presence. My desire was to hear his word. And I was in the second row back here where Sister Sabrina was in this little old church, and there was a guy bigger than me. He was sitting in my way of getting out and going to the altar. I about pushed a brother down. God came that night and he hugged me. He said, "You're my son and I'm proud of you." He healed me that night. He delivered me. He set me free. And I'm talking, there's a peace that passes all understanding that we always say in church. I got the peace that night that passes all understanding. You understand what I'm saying? I was telling Bishop one day, and I said, "Pastor, I don't understand it. There's a peace, man. There's a peace of God. I can't explain it." And he says, "Man, what is going on with you?" And as I was testifying and telling him about the good things that God was doing, I get a phone call not even an hour later, and it was my insurance company. And they said, "Mr. Chambers just wanted to verify that you were in an accident on this and this date." And I'm like, "No, I wasn't in an accident." "Well, yeah, it was in this place." And I'm like, I know who was in that place. My son was in another state. And I said, "Lord," and he was fine, but just the accident that happened that the insurance had to tell me. But you know what? I chose to remain. I chose to remain in the presence of God. And see, that's what I'm talking about. And it was not just only that situation since February 6, 2016, because when I got out of that altar and I got to the altar, there was no man that laid hands on me. You understand what I'm saying? And I thank God for the altar workers, and I thank God for the men of God that lays hands on people. But it was God. I mean, I didn't need anybody else. And he hugged me just like I hugged my daughter a while ago. And it was the best feeling I have ever felt in my life. And I just wept before the Lord. And I thanked him. You got to understand, I was hurt. And I allowed that to come in. I was dealing with things that I shouldn't have been dealing with. Taylor, come here one more time, dear. Come here. You see these chairs right here? Can you lift those up for me and kind of move them off the stage for me? Yeah, can you lift those up? What about the front? Can you get the front side? You're good. All right, put them down. See, that's what I was trying to do. I was trying to do it. I was trying, and I was quoting scripture. I'm an overcomer by the blood of the Lamb. I'm overcomer by the word of my testimony. And you know what? I just had to stop, and I had to say, Daddy. And my daddy came in. He moved the mountain, he moved the hurt, he moved the pain, and I let my daddy do it, and I didn't have to do it anymore. Is anybody in this house hearing what I'm saying? There was a woman with the issue of blood that we all know. She had this issue for 12 years. Can you imagine dealing with something for 12 years? She had no intimacy with her disease, with her sickness. She couldn't have human contact. Everything that she sat on had to be clean and purified. Everything that she slept on the bed had to be clean and purified. But she knew that there was a man that if she could just grab hold of the hem, she didn't have to touch his hand. She didn't have to hug him. All she had to do, she knew that her hope was in the hem of the garment. And she pressed her way through. I'm talking for 12 years. How long have you been wrestling? How long have you been wrestling? Come on, man. I know. I was wrestling with this thing, and I didn't even know I was wrestling with it. I was living a Christian life. And those desires that I had, even as a man, even as a youth pastor, of pride and arrogance, whatever it was, you put your name in the blank. This is what I heard, and God absolutely rocked me. Your desire for blank is greater than your desire for God. And I heard that, and I'm like, no, it is not. Yes, it was. Because my actions showed different. And I said, God, you got to help me. I can't do this. I need you to do it. And then I cried out, Daddy. You've got to understand that my biological dad left when I was 2 years old. My mom met this man when I was 2. When I turned 13, they got married when I was 2-3 years old. And when my 13th birthday, they came to me and they said, we want to adopt you. That man back there said, I want to adopt you. And that was one of the best days of my life. And I allowed the things of this world, I'm just talking the things of this world, the cares of the church, everything, to pull me away. And my Heavenly Father said, you're adopted. You're my son. I know who you are. I know your hidden desires. I know who you are. This woman suffered for 12 years. 12 years. She wrestled. He said that your desire for whatever it is greater than your desire for me. Now, you got to ask yourself that. Is it money? Is it position? Is it job? Is it retirement? What is it? Our desire has got to be honored, like honor God, like this Shunammite woman. Because when you place that, your top priority, in the name of Jesus, you enter a resting place. Your zip code changes. Is anybody hearing what I'm saying? I'm going to just declare some things in the name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. I praise you and I magnify you. Let me tell you something. Her pursuit was to honor God, who he was and who he is. He is the God of miracles. He is the God who heals. He is the God who restores. He is the God that delivers. He is the God who mends and not puts back together, but he makes it so much better. I'm talking 2 years, I've been at a place of peace and rest because I entered into his presence. I pressed through the crowd and I said, God, you're my number one priority no matter what. He is the God who brings the dead to life. He is the God who gives peace. He is the God of joy unspeakable. It's uncontainable. Is anybody hearing what I'm saying? Ask yourself that. The thing that's been holding you back for 12 years, for 2 years, for 6 months, for 40 years. What's holding you back? There's churches all over America meeting today, meeting on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And there were people that were all around Jesus. But he said, wait a minute. There's somebody who touched me with intention. There was somebody who pressed into my presence and virtue left my body. Is anybody hearing what I'm saying? They had a purpose. There's two types of people in the Bible. There's people who just came into contact with Jesus and their life was never the same. There's people who had an encounter with Jesus. And in their encounter, their life was changed forevermore. You understand what I'm saying? The man, when Jesus stepped out on the shore and he was filled with demons galore, Jesus set him free. And he became a disciple over 10 cities. I'm talking full restoration. I'm talking about full healing. Listen, guys, we don't have to live in our state of distress and stress and worry. Listen, God is the God who is still on the throne. You need to tell somebody, God is still on the throne. If he's still on the throne, then that means mercy is still flowing from heaven. That means peace is still flowing from heaven. That means his healing power is still flowing from heaven. Is anybody in this house? Do you need an encounter with Jesus? I'm telling you, if you go back and look at it, man, the woman who was healed, everything she touched was unclean until she touched Jesus. And the power that was in him was greater than her power that she had on the inside of her, and it set her free. It cleaned her up where she could have human contact. See, a lot of times we hide as Christians. We hide in the body. We hide in the church. Hey, how are you? Oh, I'm good, man. I'm good. No. We got to get back to the presence of God. Our desire has got to be God first. Everything in our life has got to be God first. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Come on, stand to your feet. You've been praying, you've been seeking God. You've put your desires to the side. You've been honoring God. If you haven't been honoring God, that's our first step. God, I want to honor you. God, I want to pick up that piece of paper in the parking lot because this is your house. God, I want to take care of my house that you have given me. You have blessed me. God, I want to take care of my family. Somebody showed me a picture this morning of a husband and wife praying over their ministry. Come on, church. It's got to be God first. If you ever see me, and I'm saying it's all about me, about this youth ministry, you come to me and tell me. You hear me? It's about God, and he gets all the glory. And I'm telling you, between the youth ministry and the children's ministry, church, I love you, but you better get ready. You better get ready. God's moving in our kids, in our youth. And there was a revival coming that we've never seen before. I'm talking signs and wonders. Because why? I'm pressing in. I know Pastor Donna's pressing in. I know Bishop's pressing in. I'm talking signs and wonders. I heard of a testimony yesterday at our vendor fair. A woman went in for an aneurysm in her brain. When they went in, there was two of them. And she's healed. This was back in 1979. And she was sitting over there witnessing, telling me how good God was. I heard yesterday of a story of a boy who had autism. No longer. God healed her. You understand what I'm saying? Listen, I pray that you know that I love you. I'm talking to my teenagers and I'm talking to my parents. Guys, you've got to be careful what you're listening to and what you're doing, what you're letting come through your eyes and these cell phones. I'm telling you that because I love you. It's not all good. Whatever is pure, whatever is holy, whatever is right, think on these things. Because then that's when the peace comes. If you're struggling and you don't have peace in your life right now, these altars are open. If you got to just touch the hem of his garment, just make up in your mind to come and touch the edge of the carpet. Come. Come. God is here. If your marriage is not right, God is here. Several years ago, my wife looked at me and told me to go my way, and I told her to go her way. And I thank God that he stepped in because it was the best decision I ever made to stay with my wife. I love that woman. And because we made the decision to stay together, it's been the best days of our life. I'm like, devil, you a lie. This is the gift that God gave me. I ain't getting rid of it. You understand what I'm saying? I had to allow God to move the mountains. I had to let God heal me. I'm a man. I'm the youth pastor. I don't get hurt. No, your flesh. And there's things that we fight. If your marriage is struggling, I challenge you to get here, press in together, and know that God put you two together. If you need God to heal you internally of some situations, things that you're struggling with, get down to this altar. If you want to know the mercy and grace and the goodness of God, you've been living a Christian life. I was living a Christian life, but I'm living a God life now. I'm telling you, I didn't understand from glory to glory. I understood it on February 6, 2016, from glory to glory. And I'm telling you, God has opened up doors that I thought would never open. Things are happening in our life that I never thought would happen because I was trying to make them happen. I moved out of the way. And I let God, hey, whatever, your will, God, not mine. Is anybody hearing me? Lord, we honor you right now. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. If you don't mind, come and sing for me. If you need to touch the hem of his garment, if you need to get into the presence of God, I want you to come. I want you to come. These altars are open. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for your word. God, I thank you and I honor you. I pray that you move upon our hearts and our minds right now. I remove any hindrance from you getting into the presence of God in the name of Jesus. By the blood of the Lamb, it doesn't matter the weight. It doesn't matter the magnitude. It doesn't matter anything. Your Heavenly Father is here, and he wants to wrap his arms around you. Today is your day to say, it is well. Today is your day to say, it is well. And watch the walls start crumbling. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Altar workers, just wait. Just wait just for a second. If you're in this altar, I want you to begin to pour out to God. It's just you and God in this room. In the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, in the name of Jesus, move across this altar. In the name of Jesus.
That is the place where I'll change. And that is where I belong.
May the fire on my altar never burn out. Make me a house of prayer. Oh, make me a house. Make me a house of prayer. A house of prayer. Lord, make me a house. Make me a house of prayer.
Do that part one more time.
Day and night, day. Day and night, day.
Come on.
Day and night, day. Make me
do it again. Do it again. I would believe the Lord would say today, He's pleased, amen. What an awesome word, amen. All of us need to find our resting place. Anybody need rest? Anybody find some rest today? One more time, would you let Pastor Chris know? Thank you for an on-time word. You know what? You can always find a good word. But sometimes, listen, you need to find a good word and a good heart. You put those two together, and I'm going to tell you, God can move right in the middle of it. Amen? Amen. Listen, I know there's others still around the altar praying. There's still some things going on over here. And God only knows what all's taking place today. Amen. But don't forget tonight, 6 o'clock at the Grace Community, 308 Raven Road. This is one of our small churches on the district. But let's go fill that place and let's let Pastor William Kemp come and bring a word to us tonight. Let's go in and help create an atmosphere in that place as well. And let's just expect great things there tonight. Amen. If it gets packed, you may have to park across the street at the, I think there's a car wash there. And it's okay to park there. Amen. So if you pull up and there's no parking, please find somewhere to park. Park down the road if you have to. Amen. Well, let's fill that church up tonight. Amen. Don't forget, go by, pick up your IP logo. All right? All minds, hearts, and souls clear. Pastor Chris.
Thank you to all the vendors and people who helped yesterday. Can we give God praise one more time? I want to say a huge thank you to everyone who came out yesterday and made it a huge success. Thank you for donations. Thank you for your time, for your hard work. Thank you for being a vendor. Thank you. Thank you to the 129 staff. You guys are absolutely the best, and I love you. So thank y'all for making it. If I name names, I'd be in trouble. But thank you for every one of you that showed up yesterday and had a part of it. Thank you.
Father, we thank you for the day. Thank you for the word that's been spoken into our spirit. God, we pray today that as we leave, that God, that you just that this word would just soak into our spirit. And the God, that we would just crawl up in your lap. As Psalm 63 declares, O God, thou art my God. Early will I seek thee. My soul searches for thee. So, Lord, today we crawl up in your lap. Nothing desiring but to just say, I love you. Amen. If you are our guest and you're still here, we'd love to meet with you in our hospitality room, present you with a free gift from the church. God bless you. Shake hands. Be friendly. Come back. We'll see you Wednesday night. The Lord willing, the rapture doesn't take place. If it does, we'll see you on the other side. Prayerfully, we'll see you tonight at the district rally.